Hello and welcome to the new OutPower tutorial. Today we'll be talking about the JavaScript API for feedback messages. We'll go through the API available functions and how we can use its parameters. Without further delay, let's give a look into this. Today we're going to cover the JavaScript API for the feedback messages that we can use when developing for mobile and reactive web applications. With this API, we can display or close feedback messages to the user. When used to display, we can personalize the feedback messages, specifying options like the custom style and auto-close behavior. This API has two methods, the close feedback message and the show feedback message. The close feedback message allows us to close the feedback message that is currently open. The show feedback message allows us to show a feedback message with the specified options such as message, style, auto-closing behavior, etc. Let's start by checking how we can use these two functions. What we have done here, just for demonstration purpose, is that we have set up a button that triggers a JavaScript node. Inside the node, we have the following JavaScript code. The show feedback message has several options available to us. We'll go through each one of them in a moment. Inside this node, we have the close feedback message JavaScript. This one does not present any options, and as the name implies it, it calls the current showing feedback message. Time for a quick demo. Okay, as you can see it, the feedback message is working as we expected. And we can even trigger the close of the feedback from another action, instead of waiting for a certain amount of time or clicking on the message. Now returning to our show feedback message JavaScript, let's explore the other available options. The close feedback message does not take any parameters and returns void. The show feedback message returns void but takes the following parameters. Message, a string that represents the message that will be displayed. Message type, this is the type of feedback message that we wish to show, and we can use the following values to specify which the type of message we want to show. 0 for info, 1 for success, 2 for warning, or 3 for error. Encode HTML. It is a Boolean parameter that by default is set to true, so that the message is treated as text. If we set this to false, we can use HTML to modify our message. Extra CSS classes. This parameter allows us to add whitespace separated class names to be added to the feedback message container to customize the appearance of the message. A close on click, a Boolean that is by default set to true, and indicates if the message box will be closed when the user clicks on it. On click. This parameter is optional and receives a function. This will execute the JavaScript function whenever a feedback message is triggered. This functionality is interesting because it opens another set of possibilities fueled by JavaScript, from clicking a button on screen to triggering an asynchronous request, etc. Now that we're a bit more familiar with all the input parameters of the show feedback message, let's modify our initial case so that we can demonstrate all of the available functionality. So we had a message and a different message type just to be different from the previous case. We'll set the encode HTML to false and modify the message so that we can customize the end result a bit more. Let's also modify the look and feel of the container a bit. Let's add a shadow and modify the content a little bit. And we can do it in this manner. We specify the necessary classes, And next, we pass the name separated by a space onto the method. We also change the onClick value. And finally, we are going to prepare a JavaScript function to be called whenever the feedback message is triggered. So let's create a script and specify the JavaScript function. Now that we have done that, we add the script to our demo page and specify the function name in the parameter space. Okay, all done. Let's see our customized feedback message in action. And there we go, our feedback where we explore all the available parameters on the method. Another way that we can use the function parameter is that instead of relying on a function that exists on a JavaScript library, we can declare the function directly in the parameter. Let's do that. So after declaring this quick test function, let's see it working. And with that, we wrap up our video tutorial on the JavaScript API for feedback messages. We hope you have enjoyed our video, and please join us next time for more OutSystems tutorials by OutPower.